the Republican Party, at least for the last 50, 60, 70 years, the Republican Party championed, you know, liberalizing trade, you know, as good for American economy. The Democrats were always conflicted on it because of the strength of the labor unions inside the Democratic Party and the approach that labor unions took to this. But then President Trump introduced kind of a new dimension. He basically said that we were taken advantage of. So I think we're now asking big questions. Where are we going with trade policy? Where do you think the country is heading on trade policy and especially this Congress?
I would say that, John, we've experienced much more of an alignment between the Republican and Democratic parties on trade policy than we've seen historically. And it really is one that President Trump pushed, obviously, of how does this benefit America and the America First policy when it came to trade. That said, America, as you know, our companies are global companies. There are many more people that live outside of America that we can build and sell the best products in the world to. And our country has benefited from that in terms of creating jobs to build products that we also can sell throughout the world and competing in the world economy. So I think where we are right now on trade is really, if you think about the Biden administration, it won't be a dramatic shift from the Trump administration's policies. They haven't yet lifted tariffs, but I think you will see more of a multinational approach. But I can tell you right now, John, you know, having run for office, out in the streets, whether it's New Hampshire or any place across the country, people understand, yes, the importance of trade in terms of our ability. You know, we're right next to Canada, of our ability to sell to Canada or Canada to sell to us. But people do have a perception and understanding that trade policy does have to first come to benefit the United States of America. And so that's where I think you see the shift from the viewpoint of average person on the street, that trade really ultimately has to be one where we think about the country first and the context in which the trade is being made. So I think this policy of trade is not going to change dramatically between the two administrations. I think the approach will change and the outreach will change, but we're still going to see a more restrictive trade policy.
Yeah, I think you're right. Probably the best indicator was the renegotiation of NAFTA, USMCA, the NAFTA agreement, because that was where the two parties came together.
You're right, John, that they were able to make an agreement on a major trade agreement. That's astounding, and it does show you that there is alignment on the parties when it comes to trade, and there are fewer disputes on those issues than there ever were historically. I think the important thing for companies that operate on a global level is really to understand the impact in particular countries you operate. I also think to make sure that policymakers understand your supply chain, understand how you manufacture things, understand that the jobs that you have in America may be dependent on your ability to sell in other markets and probably are dependent. And so I think that's where, you know, it's important for lawmakers to understand when a particular tariff is imposed or a particular restriction is proposed, that there can be an impact on American jobs, and American jobs can be lost with that. And so I think that's an area that's very important that companies engage with Washington on.